You're listening to the BBM Global Network with 25 years in broadcast audio and video production. Our passionate team creates content and marketing for the world of Internet talk radio. If you've got a passion, come join us at bbmglobalnetwork.com. The BBM Global Network. Your voice is now heard.
I should be over the things that happened to me. I'm to blame. It has to be my fault. Why else would it have happened? These are just a few of the statements many clients have said to author and mental health professional Kelly James over the years. Kelly James, the host of Why Aren't You Over This By Now, kept searching for something that would help her feel better after things that happened in her personal life. Finally, she found a way to heal her past in order to love her future and is here to share her discoveries and help the lives of others. So please welcome the host of Aren't You Over This By Now, Kelly James.
Welcome to BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. You're listening to Why Aren't You Over This By Now? I'm your host, Dr. Kelly James, and my guest today is Amber Eidem. And she is the founder of The Precious Legacy. Welcome to the show, Amber.
Thank you for having me.
I am excited. You were on a few weeks ago. And so we're going to kind of maybe redo some things that we talked about. But would you introduce yourself and tell a little bit about your backstory and how you came to be with me today?
Absolutely. So my name is Amber Eidem. I was married to an Army officer and by the name of Captain Aaron Eidem. He served nearly 20 years in the U.S. Army. He did several tours stateside and overseas. And in 2016, he was tragically killed in the line of duty. Since then, shortly after that, we have three kids. He has a son. At that time was 14. My oldest daughter was 16 and our youngest daughter was 6, which her name is Kaden, and we will talk about her and her experience with a service dog here in a little bit. But Kaden did have the closest relationship with her father. They were always attached to each other's hips whenever possible, whether it was going to work with him, eating gummy bears off of his daughter, his secretary's desk. She'd roll in the dirt at cadet 5K mud runs, and she'd even climb underneath the car in her princess dress while he was changing the oil. She's always been an experience. But bringing me here, initially we started off with social media experience with Warhawk PTSD service dogs. A few years after my husband's loss, Kaden ended up going into some therapy, but she was constantly being tossed around, and one was because she wouldn't talk about her dad. So if you wouldn't talk, I can't help you, sort of behavior. Mm-hmm. And so we found another therapist that after a year, said that she wasn't any better now. So she dropped her, and then we had another therapist that just wouldn't keep her appointment. So in that middle of time, Kaden withdrew. She closed off from the world. She stopped trusting everyone, and she just stopped believing in love. After trying to do everything I possibly could, she started talking about just not wanting to be here anymore, and I was terrified. So I ended up doing a little bit of a Facebook stalk, and I knew of an organization that we were involved in with Volunteers Dream Ride with Julie Vintage. She was close friends with Kevin Doncaster. So mm-hmm. I ended up looking for him. I reached out and wasn't reaching out for a dog. I reached out to him because I knew he was very familiar with loss and with PTSD And I wanted to know if there was anything that he could do for us and an idea of getting her out of this funk. And he asked some questions. He insisted on listening, and he gave me 5 words that started this process and changing our lives. And I said, don't worry, I got you. And so since then, I've continued to support Warhawk, and Kevin has been helping me with my efforts of the Precious Legacy.
Yeah, that's really great. And couple things. I'm sorry for your loss for your husband, and I, as a therapist, I am sorry. Apologize for the therapeutic community for not meeting your child's needs. And maybe later we can talk about the process of finding the right therapist, because that's definitely an important component in getting well. And so you've met with Kevin, and when you were on a couple of weeks ago, you actually were going to get a dog. Did you get the dog?
We did.
And what's the dog's name?
Her name is Akashi.
Akashi.
Akashi stands for Crimson. So she loved it. She watches anime. She picked Akashi from an anime, but it also signifies the thin red line from supporting our military.
Wow. And so how is the family adjusting to the new addition?
Yeah, it has been a world of emotions.
I bet.
So in the year that we have waited for Akashi, initially she was placed with another dog. She never got to meet this dog, but pictures started rolling in, and we were excited. We started telling family, but then we got the news that this particular dog wasn't going to be a good fit, personality-wise, and it just wasn't learning as quick as they had hoped. So another dog was going to be chosen. And so we just sat and waited to hear what we were going to do about that. But we didn't have to wait very long. A dog just happened to show up at the front gates of the trainer's house. Someone had dropped this dog. And they did everything they possibly could to find the owners. No one came forth. So they did an assessment and found out she was in great condition. And she actually knew some commands, some basic commands. So the only thing they could think of is the one flaw that we absolutely love the best about her is that as a Black German Shepherd, her ears never rose. So she has one that stands up and one that's kind of cockeyed to the right. And it's just quirky, and it's her perfect behavior, and she's beautiful. It was their loss, and it was perfect for us. But, we got to spend a week with her through Christmas, and they got to bond. It was instant that they, were able to just love on each other. And it was sad that we had to give her back, but she needed to continue her training. Right. But then they were hit in some serious winter storms in Oklahoma. So they lost power for several days. Everything happens, in the right timing. And, so once, they got their power back on, she started training again, and, we would take the 4-hour drive to go and visit her and to make sure that connection was still going to be active.
Sure.
And it was a long drive, but it was worth it for them to spend that much time. And, eventually on May 7th, we picked her up this May 7th, and they were united. And, so it's been interesting because for a year, she's been learning from a trainer and, not really necessarily having that connection with Peyton to train, with her. And
sure.
So that, the willingness, she's just testing her. It's like a child. She's testing her. And yes. She's like, you really want me to sit? No, you don't. And so we're going to continue a little bit of continued education so they can have that relationship and that one-on-one communication. It's also a dog that doesn't want to sleep in. She is And I'm thinking that's the shepherd. I've been told it's a shepherd behavior. So she is up by 5 a.m. no matter what you do. So you can let her out at midnight and she's still up at 5 a.m. And it's interesting with a preteen, because nobody wants a grumpy teenager. So I've been helping her out a little bit by, you know, getting up and letting her out and entertaining her and letting Caden sleep in. It's an adjustment.
I'm thinking doggy door.
We have a doggy door, but we have to leave the main door of the house door open for her to use it. So
that won't really work, will it?
It does not work. So but in the meantime of having her, Caden is starting to join group activities. She's participating in full conversations, and it's a good win.
Oh, that's really great. And when we come back, we're going to talk more about her and how she's adjusting. You're listening to Why Aren't You Over This By Now? I'm Dr. Kelly James. You're on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. We'll be right back.
Dr. RC will share extraordinary resources and services that promote educational success, as well as making a difference in the lives of all social workers, as well as the lives of children, adolescents, and teens of today. She will have open discussions addressing many of the issues that we face about our youth and how being employed in the uniquely skilled profession of social work for over 18 years has taught invaluable lessons through her personal experiences. She will also provide real-life facts, examples, and personal stories that will confirm that why serving as a child advocate is extremely beneficial when addressing the needs of the whole child. Listen live Saturdays, 10 a.m. Eastern on the BBM Global Network and tune in radio as Dr. RC will provide thought-provoking information that will empower, encourage, and strengthen students, families, and communities across our nation. You can also visit her at soarwithkatie.com. Have you ever felt like no one is listening, or you're not getting the honest attention you deserve? Do you even know the kind of attention you want or need? You are not alone. Alice Aspen March is here to help. Thanks to Alice, through her epiphany and research over the word attention, there are solutions to the attention dilemma. Worldwide audiences have been enthralled and engaged for over 40 years with her visionary and pioneering observations. The kind of attention we get and give is vital to improving our lives and society. Alice and her weekly guests review game-changing insights for transforming and improving our understanding of attention, providing techniques for creating healthier and empowering behavior. Get a new perspective on a mainstream word. Tune into Why Our Attention Matters for fresh and thought-provoking conversations every Tuesday at 3 p.m. Eastern on boldbravemedia.com and the TuneIn Radio app.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. James, and you are listening on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio to the show Why Aren't You Over This By Now? My guest today is Amber Eidem, the founder of The Precious Legacy. And Amber, so what is The Precious Legacy?
Yeah, absolutely. So The Precious Legacy is an organization that has been created. It's honestly only 4 months new. We started back before COVID, put it off to the side, and once everything started shutting down. And, it started when I myself applied for a family retreat, and that would also accept aged out, children. So my oldest daughter at the time would have been 20. And so she was considered aged out. And so we got rejected because he wasn't KIA. And it just crushed her. I saw her so deflated. And I knew there had to be something that needed to be done. And I didn't necessarily want to be the one to do it because I am a major introvert. And so I just kind of sat back and watched and hoped that somebody else would do something. And at church, I mean, honestly, the pastor at that weekend, it was, he preached about, using God's gifts. And then, if you say there's something that needs to be done, then, you know, you need to be the one to do it, not waiting for somebody else to take care of that. I was like, whoa, I think he's singing to me.
So welcome to the world, you know, of extroversion.
yeah. So I had to get outside of my comfort zone big time. And it just weighed on my heart. So I started talking to other gold stars. And I started hearing more stories about children that were left out of other organizations and events, retreats, because of their age. So then I started reaching out to some gold stars that I attended retreats with, got them on my board. And so then the Precious Legacy was created. In our mission, we will bring support and lifelong bonds by bringing together gold star young adults. Our focus is on 19 to 24 year olds.
Okay. Right here, would you mind sharing what gold star is? Because I know we've probably all heard that term, but what does it actually mean?
Right. So gold stars was actually a term that was used back in 1936. Initially, it was focused on mothers, but it is now described to be any American survivor whose immediate service member, whether it be their son, spouse, parent, has been killed or has died while serving in the United States military.
Okay.
So in that meantime, you know, and it is amazing, like, how many actual military don't even know what a gold star is. So you start talking to them and you say, gold star, and they're like, what's that? And I'd be guilty of that myself. And so I became one. And then it's been like a part of my goal to really get it out to be known and seen, because there's several children who are dealing with this. And then, you know, back in 2015 was the last time they actually did a count of survivors. And that was a total of 1 million, I think it was like 1,076,803 surviving children. And that was just back in 2015. And I'm sure it's either the same, if not more, today.
Wow, so it is so important. That's a lot of kids. Yes.
It is a lot of kids, over a million children. And, you know, so by this, you know, by doing just this little act, you know, I'm going to bring these young adults together to give them that support, that meeting of others that are like them, and helping each other heal. It's helping to find a purpose of their own. And most of these have never even met another gold star. So this will also give them a chance to have that bond, have that support that they have needed, because this group of gold stars are all going to understand one another. So they're just going to get it. Yeah. And so that's why, in that sense, it is, and at this age, they strive to uphold their service members' legacy. And we want to fill in that gap to let them know, one, they already are. But we also want to do that by giving them a weekend to relax, to have fun, and just be kids. So we did. We gave our motto is walking in their footsteps, but creating our own path.
Which is such a great motto. It really, it's very impactful. Yeah.
Yeah. We want them to know that they don't have to do it alone. Yeah, and then that we can fight together, and they are always going to be loved, and our service member can be remembered, but they're already proud of them. So now it's for them to, you know, walk hand in hand with someone who will understand their grief, but also know that they are their own individual, you know, selves, and it's time for them to create their own story.
Sure. And what a great opportunity, because you said you're focusing on 19 to 24, and then when they age out of your organization, they've established those bonds with each other and can continue on with themselves. Yeah, what a great opportunity. Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah, we're
very passionate about this. Yeah, I'm really, it's, you know, because it's hard to lose a parent. My father died when I was 13, and it's hard to lose a parent when you're young, especially, you know, you're still developing, you're still needing that input from that parent, and then they're just not there. Yeah, so what a great opportunity for these individuals, these early adults, if we can call them that, that they get to make some really impactful relationships with each other. When we come back from break, we'll continue talking about the Precious Legacy and how you can help. You're listening on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio to Why Aren't You Over This By Now. I'm Dr. Kelly James. Be sure and stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Master of words, powerful player. What life-changing words can Dr. Janet Smith Warfield pull out of her magical toolbox that just might mysteriously open a door you never knew was there? A door to free yourself from fear forever. Transform your rage into right action. Release your guilt. Position you into a life of freedom, purpose, passion, power, and peace. All quite suddenly, unexpectedly, and almost miraculously, with no effort on your part. Join Dr. Janet every Monday at noon Eastern on Dancing with Words, Dancing with Wisdom on the BBM Global Network as she and her guests show you how words map our experiences, immersing you in a sound bath that relaxes your muscles, opens your mind, and supports you in co-creating your extraordinary life. What if there were a super... Have you ever felt like no one is listening or you're not getting the honest attention you deserve? Do you even know the kind of attention you want or need? You are not alone. Alice Aspen March is here to help. Thanks to Alice, through her epiphany and research over the word attention, there are solutions to the attention dilemma. Worldwide audiences have been enthralled and engaged for over 40 years with her visionary and pioneering observations. The kind of attention we get and give is vital to improving our lives and society. Alice and her weekly guests review game-changing insights for transforming and improving our understanding of attention, providing techniques for creating healthier and empowering behavior. Get a new perspective on a mainstream word. Tune into Why Our Attention Matters for fresh and thought-provoking conversations every Tuesday at 3 p.m. Eastern on boldbravemedia.com and the TuneIn Radio app.
Welcome back to Why Aren't You Over This By Now. I'm Dr. Kelly James, and you're listening on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. My guest today is Amber Eidem, and we're talking about the Precious Legacy, the organization that you created, developed for, you know, these children, these who have aged out. And in our talking before this show, you shared just a little bit, and don't share anything you're not willing to share, but you kind of alluded to having your own trauma. Can you talk about how that propelled you to take this step in creating this organization for others who've experienced trauma?
Absolutely. You know, back in, you know, when we were young, we'd do foolish things. And I was very young and naive and got married super early, had a baby, and definitely was not having the right mindset of what was really good for me. And I mean, I was 18, and I mean, what 18-year-old really knows much? You know, you ask them, they know everything, but...
There's not a single 18-year-old alive who knows what life is.
Exactly. But I thought I was a grown-up at that point. So, you know, unfortunately, I ended up getting involved into a very abusive relationship. It was not healthy. It was mentally abusive, mainly. And if anything, that scarred me more than any physical that happened. And I carried that even through after my divorce. And, you know, after my divorce, I ended up staying pretty much a hermit. I was terrified of letting anyone in. And I was convinced to go out and start living life again. And at 21, I finally got out and started experiencing life again for the very first time, and then was attacked by an individual. And
I'm so sorry.
And it definitely, it was something that I held very secretive and very quiet because I was ashamed, and I didn't know what kind of mark I was going to be given. So my entire life, I kept it quiet. And Even after that, when I got married to Aaron, it was something I kept secret for a long time. And I finally opened up and shared with him because he didn't understand why I was so reserved. Mm-hmm. And we'd always had a guard up. I was always protecting myself. I'd always question like everything he did. And eventually, opening it up, he was, very willing to, walk me through and understand, why when he said I was beautiful, I didn't believe him. Why he, when he said, I loved you, I questioned him, and, it was a lot that to carry on, throughout, in that abuse relationship. I miscarried, due to being pushed to the ground. So I lost, a child, and it was many things throughout life that you stack on top. And then, when I lost my husband, it was a major, major stop in life.
Sure.
There's nothing that prepares you for that. And, I turned that grief, I think, into strength. And that's how I chose to use it. I used it as what can I do to help others? And in that sense, and I think when I lost my husband, I didn't know what to do with it. And, so when I reached out to my children instead, and then I noticed they needed something. And then I was like, well, if they need something, more need it. And I use it to help now, hopefully, to reach out to as many, of these kids I can get reach.
Yeah, I'm sorry that you had to experience that. I always hate that people have to experience trauma, but my personal thoughts are that no one gets through life without some type of trauma. And the reason the mental abuse is more impactful is because that kind of absorbs into our psyche of what we believe about ourselves. Whereas if you're being physically abused, you only feel threatened when that person's around, but those tapes in your head play nonstop. And you talked about shame, and shame is what keeps us bound, is my own, because I was abused as a child. And when I started telling my story is when I started standing a little taller. So I'm really appreciative of you sharing that with the audience.
Yeah. I have learned that by talking about it, I feel proud. I feel proud. I can tell my story. And in the middle of that, maybe I can help someone else, because it does show hope that you don't have to allow it to own you. And, you choose to own it and then take control over it.
Right.
And it's definitely difficult. And I think everybody's heard the seven, steps of grief. Everyone knows that. But what they're not telling you is, there's no order to it. There's no timeline for it. They can repeat. Then some of them you may never even get over. And, and they're always triggers. And even especially with living with grief of a loss, I think that's where that PTSD starts bringing it in, because the triggers are the hardest. And it could be in any type of abuse situation, could be the same. And, some you expect, like anniversaries, birthdays, holidays, it's things that you forget, like songs, smells, one thing is my daughter graduated, soon she's going to get married. And it's those things that when you have that loss, like, it's hard because you can't share that with the person that you really loved.
Right. Yeah, those. And Dr. Bessel van der Kolk wrote a book called The Body Keeps the Score. And it's an excellent book on trauma, but your body remembers before you do. And so when those anniversaries come up, your body's going to respond to that, and you'll feel off, you feel off kiltered. And then if you just go, is this an anniversary? You'll remember that those are coming up.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's really an important thing to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's why I think I want to bring so much awareness for these young adults with PTSD. With over a million surviving children with PTSD now walking around, any of them are even at an age that don't even know how to express it. They don't know the words. They don't know, they don't even know what they're feeling. Yeah. It's hard.
Yeah, and kind of the trauma experts, we talk about you integrate those memories back into the whole of yourself. You can't ever undo the trauma that you've experienced, but you integrate it back into your whole so it no longer negatively impacts you. We'll talk more when we come back from break. I'm Dr. Kelly James, and you're listening to Why Aren't You Over This By Now on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. Be sure and stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Author, radio show host, and coach John M. Hawkins reveals strategies to help gain perspective, build confidence, find clarity, achieve goals. John M. Hawkins' new book, Coached to Greatness, Unlock Your Full Potential with Limitless Growth, published by iUniverse. Hawkins reveals strategies to help readers accomplish more. He believes the book can coach them to greatness. Hawkins says that the best athletes get to the top of their sport with the help of coaches, mentors, and others. He shares guidance that helps readers reflect on what motivates them, rediscover and assess their core values, philosophies, and competencies, find settings that allow them to be the most productive, and track their progress towards accomplishing goals. Listen to John Hawkins' My Strategy, Saturdays, 1 p.m. Eastern, on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. The opiate epidemic has reached crisis levels, and with so many families affected by addiction, opiate-related drug overdoses, and death, the time is now to have a real constructive conversation about addiction that could lead to better prevention, treatment, and recovery. Alan Charles, author and keynote speaker on drug abuse and prevention, presents The Alan Charles Show. Alan brings a message of hope, sharing his unbelievable story of surviving a 24-year addiction to cocaine and highlights from his memoir, Walking Out the Other Side, An Addict's Journey from Loneliness to Life. His raw honesty and courageous heart breaks the stigma of addiction and offers a unique perspective into the mind of an addict. Join Alan each week as he brings his listeners to a true understanding of the grip of addiction. It is only with this understanding that we can begin to heal. The Alan Charles Show, Thursdays at 9 p.m. Eastern on the BBM Global Network.
Welcome back to Why Aren't You Over This By Now? I'm Dr. Kelly James, and you're listening on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. My guest today is Amber Eidem, and she's the founder of the Precious Legacy Organization. And we talked some heavy stuff, so let's talk about some fun stuff for your organization. You have planned a retreat. What do you want to share about that retreat? And that seems so exciting for those kids.
You know, I was told 4 months ago that it was not enough time to make this happen, but I have always been the type of person to prove people wrong. So
good for you. Good for you.
So now, we've had some hiccups and struggles, and we're starting to get focused and really start to push this out. But, you know, our retreats are going to be all expense paid except for travel. So as long as the attendee can make it to the location, we have a shuttle that we can pick up from an airport, and they're willing to drive. But our first retreat is going to be at a beautiful secluded lake house in Shawnee, Oklahoma. The dates are June 3rd through to June 7th. It is a co-ed retreat. We are asking for only 19 to 24-year-olds. There is absolutely no duty status or manner of death. We accept all. All are welcome. We want everyone to apply, but we will set up spots in this order. So we will start with gold stars that have never attended a retreat. The whole point of the Precious Legacy was to bring these kids together who have not had an experience. So we will focus on those kids first. Sure. Then we will get those ones that have had not only attended one or two retreats. And then after that, we will have a first come, first serve order.
Okay.
And then I guess with some activities, I'm sure everybody wants to know, what are we going to do?
Yes.
So every retreat is going to be pretty much different depending on location and availability.
Sure.
But to get a little bit of an idea of what we'll be doing, so we'll always have two larger activities that will be held away from the lodge. We like to leave those secret just until the attendees get there. We want to leave a little bit of a surprise, but we will always work on having a speaker or a guest to to the focus in aid and education, professional help, someone who is going to be focused on building up their inner spirit. And we are thrilled to have Tammy Imlay with us this year to be a motivational speaker for our group. Meals will always be homemade right there at the launch, but our final dinner out will be together in a restaurant out in town to give these kids a chance to dress up and show off a little bit.
Nice. That's fun.
This year on our property, we have, we offer swimming, fishing, we have kayaks, there's a basketball court. We'll do a craft. I know the boys will just love that, but we will have a craft. And there's always going to be pastoral or grief counseling available by phone if requested. So that is always going to be there. And don't forget all the photo ops. We are definitely going to be picture perfect. So everybody be ready to take some bunch of snaps.
Oh, that sounds great. And so how do people get hold of you? Because I know your website is now live.
It is. Our website is live at theprecislegacy.org. You'll find all our, there's waivers, there's information on there. You'll even have a picture of the retreat location. But it's also a great location is at The Precious Legacy on Facebook. That's where you're going to find all our updates. You're going to see all of our exciting newses and anything that you want right now, right away, is going to be right there. So check us out on Facebook. We also have an email, theprecislegacy@gmail.com. If there's anything that you have a question about, you know, send us an email and we'll get right back to you. Or in our Instagram, at, it's theprecislegacy1, which is also linked to our Facebook. So it'll be a lot of that same information. We'll be posting on both.
Okay. Are you a 501c3?
So, starting June 1st, we will have most likely, we're hoping by June 1st, we will have our 501. We have reached out to an organization, Holbrook Farms Retreat, which is it's a wellness retreat, spa-like, out in Minnesota. I've been to that retreat. I highly recommend attending. And we reached out to them, and we are looking at doing a subsidiary with them. And with a little bit of the grace of God, we will be active June 1st with our nonprofit.
Very good. And so then if anyone is out there that needs a donation, I know, you know, here's a great place of giving back to the community of service men and women who have given their lives in the line of duty and as they've served us to keep us safe. So this is a great opportunity to do that. So that's really exciting. And do you have anyone registered yet?
We have three. We have two ladies and one gentleman. If I know it's a week away, but if anybody is interested, we still have those three spots available. We were only going to take six this year. It'll be 10 to 12 after this year. So, you know, being so new, we were just trying to get a few kids in there to get that experience, get some feedback. But we do have three. And like I said, if anybody is interested, reach out to us by our email or reach out to us by Facebook, and we can get you signed up and get you in.
Well, and who knows, the six individuals that you have this year, they may become camp counselors for other retreats because they're the initiates. Very cool. This sounds like a lot of fun.
We're excited to do it. Lots of fun things planned.
And it's been warm enough in Oklahoma that the water should be warm enough so they can swim in each other. Yeah. All right. We'll share more when we come back from break. You're listening to Aren't You Over This By Now on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. I'm your host, Dr. Kelly James, and we will be right back. Be sure and stay tuned.
MJ Domit is the owner of Expect to Be Empowered, a company whose specialty is empowering people to live their best life by following their heart and accepting themselves unconditionally. After studying and making personal changes, MJ now focuses on giving others tools for self-empowerment. She provides individual and group workshops for people who are physically, emotionally, and spiritually blocked. Inspired by her work at Expect to Be Empowered, MJ authored the book Waves of Blue Light, Heal the Heart and Free the Soul, with accompanying empowerment cards. She is a Spirit Book of the Year Gold Medal Living Now Book Award winner. And her book is a number one Amazon bestseller in spirituality and was a 2012 Gold Medal winner, recognized as the Living Now Spirit Book of the Year. An inspirational speaker, MJ will show you how you can repurpose every area of your life. Your life did not just happen to you. You chose it, which means you can change it. Visit www.expecttobeempowered.com or call 866-264-8024.
If you seek a courageous advocate prepared to champion your rights with consumer service agencies that support aging populations, Carol Ann Hamilton is the one for you. Carol Ann is an elder care coach, author, and speaker with a 250,000 hours lived experience successfully supporting uncopable aging parents. As a result of a challenging journey, Carol Ann revolutionizes how stressed out caregivers restore serenity to their worlds. She also brings over 25 years of change management expertise in Fortune 500 settings to catalyze urgent transformation within the elder care industry. Carol Ann is a popular speaker at conferences across North America. She has appeared via TV, radio, and print globally. Now you can tune in weekly to get a dose of her inspiration plus down-to-earth advice to cope with even the most difficult aging parents. Listen Wednesdays at 9 a.m. Eastern on Bold Brave Media and TuneIn Radio.
Welcome back to BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. You're listening to the show, Why Aren't You Over This By Now? I'm your host, Dr. Kelly James, and my guest today is Amber Eidem with The Precious Legacy. And so, Amber, in starting this, you know, I've started other things, and you like, I don't know what I'm doing. So the learning process for you. Have there been any organizations that have hindered your process, your progress in getting this, and any that have helped you?
Yeah, you know, I've been told by many other organizations of some horror stories from them. And fortunately, I haven't experienced any backlash by any other organization so far, but actually it's been quite the opposite. I did a survivor outreach services as a dine and dial informational call, and I was requested to join that and talk a little bit about the Precious Legacy very early on. And I was from that communications, I was reached out by Tuesday's Children, Liz Zirkle. She's absolutely a beautiful woman. I love her personality, such high energy. Tuesday's Children was initially created for the survivors of 9/11. Mm-hmm. So when she reached out to me, she was like, what can we do? What can I help you? And so I think that's going to be a relationship that will be right from the very beginning. Sure. Of course, Warhawk PTSD Service Dogs has been a huge advocate, you know, or Kevin does dogs and people. I'm doing surviving children as service members. And so with our initiative with being in the same in the fact that we want to fight PTSD. And we want to show that they never have to fight that battle alone. And of course, we absolutely love our Holbrook Farms retreat. And it's with their having, I've been to that. Again, I highly recommend looking them up. I highly get on their wait list. If you want to unplug, unwind, laugh, cry, have a good time with some other ladies, that is the perfect place to go. It's so small, 10 to 12 people. It feels like a family. And these, it's also, you know, being ran and founded by service members themselves. Mm-hmm. And now we're going to join forces and be that part of their 501, and we're just going to help each other grow. It's not been a negative so far. Yeah. I'm hoping and praying that will stay that way.
Definitely. And I think as we join together in kind of interlock and help each other, then we help more people. Because, yeah, you know, I've been working in this field since 97, and mainly see people with trauma. That's pretty much all I see, actually. And PTSD, trauma can be healed. You do not have to live the rest of your life with that as a daily reminder. It can be healed. So I just love what you're doing and sharing that you can heal this and you don't have to do it alone. So that's, I love
Absolutely.
That. Okay.
Yeah.
So when your husband died, you were grieving, your children were grieving. I don't want to be insensitive at all, but how do you do that? How do you grieve your own loss and still be present to help your children? That you have to be a superwoman to be able to do that.
No, not at all. And honestly, I can't answer for everyone because I think everybody grieves differently and they all have a different story. So I know my particular self, I really struggle with it because I put myself aside because my kids needed me. And sure. So my focus at that moment was, hey, they don't need me a mess. And, I found that time, when I went to bed, I'd lose it. When I went in the closet, I'd lose it. In the shower, I lost it. In the car, I lost it. I had those times where I broke down and I hated that I had to feel strong for my kids because I needed to show them that I also missed him. And sure. So there were those times we'd have a conversation and I would cry in front of them because I think it was good for them to see that, I missed him too. But I wasn't going to be selfish in the sense of taking that time for me. And I don't think I ever necessarily ever took that time. I've literally just constantly focused on them. And I think that's just me. And I, again, will say that it's different for everyone. And I don't think there's a right or wrong way. I think it's just, you have to find what works for you. And I don't think you necessarily heal from the trauma. I think you learn to live with the trauma. And I think you learn to walk. You learn to become strong. You learn to how to modify and change and you grow. And it's like with anything else in life, you're going to find your new you. And that's what we've all had to do.
Yeah, definitely. I had a client who shared that their mom died when they were young. And, 50 years later, the father said, I didn't realize you children were grieving. And children grieve. No matter how young they are, they grieve. They feel that loss also. And so you're right. Grieving is done differently by everyone. And part of, as a therapist, self-care is vitally important. So what do you do to care for you?
That's a question I get asked all the time. And honestly, I don't know if I can answer that. I'm the worst person to take care of me. And I'm somebody who will work until I pass out. And it's hard for me to stop. And I think that's part of that grief is because if I stop, I think. If I think, I get sad. So I think when I am doing something bigger, then I feel better. And then even in my own home, I bought a home so I could remodel it because I didn't want to stop. I literally gutted everything. I started redoing it. And it's just, I think that's how I've always done life. And even through all my, all my trauma, it's just how I've dealt with me. Is that be busy? Is that me?
Well, we're supposed to be human beings, not human doings. And I have been, guilty of a human doing for a long time. So I appreciate you being vulnerable and sharing that. When we come back from break, we'll wrap up. You're listening on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio to Why Aren't You Over This By Now. I'm Dr. Kelly James. Be sure and stay tuned. We'll be right back.
The opiate epidemic has reached crisis levels, and with so many families affected by addiction, opiate-related drug overdoses, and death, the time is now to have a real constructive conversation about addiction that could lead to better prevention, treatment, and recovery. Alan Charles, author and keynote speaker on drug abuse and prevention, presents The Alan Charles Show. Alan brings a message of hope, sharing his unbelievable story of surviving a 24-year addiction to cocaine and highlights from his memoir, Walking Out the Other Side, an addict's journey from loneliness to life. His raw honesty and courageous heart breaks the stigma of addiction and offers a unique perspective into the mind of an addict. Join Alan each week as he brings his listeners to a true understanding of the grip of addiction. It is only with this understanding that we can begin to heal. The Alan Charles Show, Thursdays at 9 p.m. Eastern on the BBM Global Network. Did you know that your beliefs create your entire reality, but it's the subconscious beliefs that do most of the creating? Belief shifter and life coach Shiraz can help you identify those limiting beliefs and eliminate them, often in a single session.
Like, it was almost instant, like I had relief right away.
Creating better health, relationships, careers, and finances. Let Shiraz help you step out of safety and into awareness.
Definitely something's happening. It's like a flow inside. Yeah, it feels good.
Whether in person or online, Shiraz provides personal coaching, belief shifting. Visit Shiraz at energeticmagic.com or call 416-529-7429. Energetic Magic on the BBM Global Network, Tuesdays at 7 p.m. Eastern. Find your greater happiness. Be well. Be aware. Be magical.
Welcome back to Why Aren't You Over This By Now on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. I'm Dr. Kelly James, and we've been talking with Amber Eidem of Precious Legacy. And so, Amber, if the sky was the limit, or as far past the sky as you can go, what are your dreams for the Precious Legacy?
Well, right now, our plan and our dream is to eventually just start spanning out and reaching as many states as we can to make it easier for them to reach us. We know that, you know, with them having to cover their travel costs, it's not going to be easy for, you know, us being in the Midwest or somebody out on the coast. And so we figure if we can come closer to you, you can make it to us.
Okay.
So that is ours.
Is there a time that you think you would have multiple retreats a year in different locations?
Oh, man, we'd love it. And of course, that also comes down to funds. I know as soon as we get the 501 subsidiary active, you'll start seeing that little donate button on our website, and we'll be sharing it on Facebook. And you know, any assistance, any help, you can always email us, again, at preciouslegacy@gmail.com. If you're wanting to, sponsor a retreater, you want to sponsor an entire retreat, anything. We're always looking for volunteers, and, I'm hoping, you know, the 5-year outlook is, you know, maybe at that point we can start carrying enough to have 2 retreats.
And yeah, 'cause I know an organization that I'm involved in, they do like a West Coast, East Coast swap years. And so multiple retreats would be really beneficial. Yeah. That would be great.
Yeah, there's some brainstorming going on and how we can reach as many as we can in a short amount of time.
Sure. So if anyone has the funds to be able to donate to allow these kids to heal what they need to heal from their tremendous loss, be sure and contact Amber. Tell your website again.
It is at thepreciouslegacy.org.
Okay, and it's up. It's live. I was on there the other day looking around and reading there. And you said that after the retreat, you'll have pictures from the retreat so people can see how much fun everyone had. And I have really appreciated you coming on and sharing your story and being vulnerable. I really appreciate that.
Kelly, I just thank you for having me, and you know, sharing about Precious Legacy and helping get the word out and hopefully reach as many kids as we can and combat this PTSD.
Yeah. Combating PTSD is definitely a goal because, you know, I have on my website kind of my tagline is love your future by healing your past. And when we heal those memories, when we heal those pains, we get to go live the life we want, the legacy that we deserve. So I really appreciate your organization and giving kids that opportunity to make connections.
Yes, I'm excited. I'm excited. Big things are planned. So just keep an eye out on the website and you'll see where our next adventure will be.
Good. And congratulations to your daughter for graduating. That's a big accomplishment. So very good.
So exciting. Big things there too.
Yeah. And she's going to graduate school.
She is headed to Duquesne University for grad school.
Very nice. Good for her. For her. And the dog. So thank you for sharing about your dog and that experience. So I'm looking forward to reading about how that progresses and how they bond with each other. So, and your daughter
is so much fun watching them.
Oh, good. And have you seen a difference in her since she's had the dog?
I have. She's definitely more outgoing. She's willing to hold a conversation. She's had the personality. She's fun. It's just been such a blessing.
I'm so glad. I'm so glad. And we didn't get to talk a lot about how to find the right therapist. We'll do that another time. So again, I appreciate your time and sharing about your wonderful organization. You've been listening on BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio to Why Aren't You Over This By Now. I'm Dr. Kelly James. Be sure and stay tuned to next week's show. We'll be back then.
You've been listening to Why Aren't You Over This By Now with your host, Kelly James. Kelly says, the truth is that we all have things that happen in our lives. We all have stuff. You can live life the way you want. Tune in each week and discover that there's hope for healing your past beyond traditional talk therapy. Right here on Kelly James's Why Aren't You Over This By Now?
Been listening to the BBM Global Network. The ideas, views, and opinions of this broadcast are those of the participants of the program and are not necessarily the ideas, views, and opinions of the BBM Global Network Company.